Thank you, sir.
Vinod Kumar.
Sir, thank you, sir, for giving this opportunity for me to speak on the no confidence motion. Sir, first let us thank the Honorable Speaker Madam for allowing a discussion on the no confidence motion in this monsoon session. Sir, there were many disruptions in the budget session on the same issue. Sir, normally the no confidence motion will be discussed on the performance and the non-performance of the government. Sir, after 4 years, we are debating regarding the performance and non-performance of the government, and the speakers who spoke just before me made some observations with regard to the performance and non-performance of the government also. Sir, I can say people's expectation of this government across the nation are not fulfilled, and their expectations are not fulfilled by Modi's government. Sir, particularly the people of Telangana were annoyed on the first day of the governance of this government. Sir, you are well aware the first cabinet of the Modi's government took a decision in promulgating an ordinance which is against the spirit of the constitution, a ordinance which took away 8 mandals from Khammam district, 7 mandals from Khammam district in the Telangana states. No, Mr. Jaydev, you are misled and you are not having the correct information.
Mr. Jaydev,
Khammam.
Please address the chair.
Part of Warangal district. Do you know it? Till 1952. Khammam was part of Warangal district, and Khammam fort became a state district in the year 1952 in the Hyderabad state. So that is the fact which you are not aware.
Please address the chair. Please.
Sir, you please give some time to us, sir. Sir, those 7 mandals were snatched away from the state of Telangana, which is a new bond, sir. Sir, when a bill was introduced in this house to replace the ordinance, we, the members of Telangana Rashtra Samiti, took serious objection. I think all the members of the house should recollect the first day of the 16th Lok Sabha, we discussed at length, sir, regarding the measure of those mandals in the Andhra Pradesh. Sir, this decision was taken by the Honorable Prime Minister Modi ji and their Chief Minister, Mr. Chandra Babu Naidu. During their honeymoon period,
in the honeymoon period,
sir, this decision was taken in the honeymoon period. Sir, Mr. Chandra Babu Naidu took, yes, Chandra Babu Naidu told many a times to the press also that I did not took oath as a chief minister till these mandals were merged in the Andhra Pradesh. Sir. No, you go through the record. Sir, Chandra Babu Naidu himself expressed that I demanded the Prime Minister that until and unless these bundles are merged in the state of Andhra Pradesh, I am not going to take oath as the Chief Minister of the Andhra Pradesh. So those were the days, sir. Sir, whatever it may be, sir, the first decision of Modi's government, sir, annoyed us, and the people of Telangana will never forgive this government, sir. So we demand here a new bill should bring into this house to amend the Andhra Pradesh State Reorganization Act and see that those 7 mandals are once again merged in the state of Telangana. Sir, why I am asking this issue? Because, sir, a hydel project in these mandals, Sileru Hydel project, sir. Sir, Telangana was a new bond state. Immediately, there was a dearth of power in this state, sir. Sir, a Hydel project was snatched away from the Telangana state, sir. And moreover, the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh took a decision against the Section 92 of the Act, sir. Section 92 of the AP State Reorganization Act ensured the state of Telangana that power should be supplied from the Andhra Pradesh government till we construct our own power projects. Sir, unfortunately, that government took that decision. In spite of it, sir, our Chief Minister, Mr. K. Chandrasekhar Rao, who is popularly known as KCR, sir. Sir, he took a decision immediately. He went to the neighboring states and entered into purchase agreement with Chhattisgarh and other states, and we purchased power. The people of Telangana, particularly the farming community, 24/7 hours supply, sir, power supply. Nowhere in the state, and that is free power and full power without any interpretation, sir. So later on, sir, our government opposed the ordinance, and later on, sir, in the AP State Reorganization Act, sir, Polavaram project, which they are now constructing. Today, Mr. Jaydev requested for some amount. We are not concerned with their request with regard to the allocation of funds. We are not coming in the way. Let them have whatever amount they want. Sir, what happened, sir? In Polavaram project, sir, at the time of enacting the act, the Congress government also never thought of Telangana state, sir. Sir, it ensured the Andhra state for allocation of funds from the central government to their Polavaram project. Sir, Telangana, the demand for Telangana came on few demands, sir. The first demand was regarding water allocation. We have two rivers, sir, Godavari and Krishna. And as you know, sir, Telangana is on the Deccan Plateau. We have to lift water from both the rivers, one from the Godavari, the other from the Krishna. Sir, immediately after formation of the state of Telangana, our Chief Minister, Mr. KCR, sir, he went to the neighboring state, Maharashtra, and made a request for constructing a dam at Tumidihatti. They refused. So immediately we re-engineered the Pranahita Chevella project, and we are constructing three barrages on River Godavari, that is at Medigadda, Sundilla and Annaram. Sir, we could convince the Maharashtra government, and later on, we all the members of parliament in Delhi, we could approach the ministries, different ministries, the Honorable Environment Minister is also here, and we could ensure that the permissions were given to all these projects, sir. Sir, now the Congress party in our state are making hue and cry, and they are approaching at different forums in the court and trying to stall these projects. The Congress party, the UPA government, failed to ensure financial assistance to these projects, either at on river Godavari or on Krishna. So now we request the Honorable Prime Minister to make an announcement today. The people of Telangana, 4 crore people of Telangana are watching, are going to hear, or they feel that Honorable Prime Minister should make an announcement today in this house for allocation of funds for the projects we are constructing on Krishna River and on River Godavari. They can choose whichever project they want, but such projects should be declared as a national project, and we should be given some amount as they are giving it to the Polavaram. Here, sir, the Congress party, in its enactment, they failed to make a clause in the section, so that had it been there, today we would have asked the government to implement the act, but unfortunately that was not ensured. But however, our Chief Minister, after getting all these permissions the required statutory permissions. We have approached many financial institutions, and now we could get some amount through borrowings, and we are constructing those projects, sir. Sir.
So very briefly, please try.
No, sir, no, sir. Nobody is speaking on this act. All these parties are speaking other than the act on which Mr.
No, please, you address it. Please, don't divert.
Jayadeva has spoken, sir.
Come to the point.
Nobody has. They are not serious on our subject. So you should give some time. The motion is moved on the subject regarding the AP State Reorganization Act. So you should give some time to us, sir. Sir, regarding the other provisions in the Act, sir, the most important issue is with regard to the assurance given to us, sir. Sir, they have assured to give us a tribal university. Sir, day before yesterday, the government of India had enacted a law and gave a central university to the state of Andhra Pradesh. Sir, there is a assurance in the act for a tribal university to the state of Telangana. And our government has shown 180 acres of land for construction of such a university, but to this day, they have not come forward. And I hope that today, the Honorable Prime Minister will also answer on these issues. Sir, there is another assurance regarding a construction of a steel factory in Bayaram by sale. That is categorically mentioned in the Act, but to this day, nothing happened, sir. They have not taken any steps to see that such a factory is constructed in the state of Telangana. Sir, regarding the other assurance, some are fulfilled to some extent, sir. Regarding the National Thermal Power Project, sir, yes, we were ensured about 4,000 megawatts, but now already they have taken steps to construct a 1,600 megawatt project at Ramagundam. We are happy to see that project coming up, sir. With regard to the national highways, this was also ensured in our act, sir. Sir, I'm happy to mention here that before the formation of Telangana, the density of the national highways as per the square kilometers was only 2.5. Now it has gone up to 5 kilometers per 100 square kilometers. We are happy to also mention that the Honorable Minister, Mr. Gadkari, has gave consent for all these projects, sir. Sir, with regard to railways, there is a demand during the Telangana agitation itself, sir, regarding construction of a railway coach factory at Kazipet. So this was also ensured in the Act, but to this day, the government has not taken any steps for construction of a railway coach factory at Kazipet, sir. So the other railway lines which we asked, they are under consideration, and I am not going to say anything regarding the railway project, sir, because they are all under now consideration. Land acquisition process is under process. We hope that shortly those will come up. Sir, regarding the High Court, it is most important, sir. Sir, High Court was under Section 31 of the AP State Reorganization Act. So this act specifically mentioned about having two high courts for the two successor states, sir. That is one for the Telangana, other for the Andhra Pradesh. The Honorable Former Law Minister, Mr. Sadananda Gowda ji, is very much here, sir. He had made a statement in the House that it will be considered as early as possible in the year 2016. Sir, to this day, nothing happened, sir. Sir, it is only because of the their Chief Minister. Sir, they have constructed.
Want to build a city,
sir, they have constructed a secretariat. They have constructed
a city, but not a
sir, they have constructed a secretariat, state assembly in record time, sir. But they have not taken steps to construct a high court.
Sir, within short time, they have constructed assembly and they have constructed secretariat, but they have not taken steps to construct a building for the High Court, sir.
Sir, this is only with ill motive. I want to say ill motive, because the present High Court at Hyderabad, which serves on both the states, sir, majority of the judges are not from our region, sir. Sir, I don't want to attribute anything, but unfortunately, they have ill intention for not having their own High Court. Sir, why they are not coming forward to have their own High Court? That's my issue. That's what I want to ask. Sir, 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 our Chief Minister, sir, in spite of all these hurdles, he has taken steps. Sir, two flagship programs, particularly with regarding the rural community. One is restoration of water bodies, sir. That is Mission Kakatiya. Sir, we are restoring around 46,000 water bodies in the state of Telangana. Sir, the Niti Aayog, which is the brainchild of the Honorable Prime Minister, sir, it proposed 5,000 crore for this flagship program, sir. Sir, many a times, under the leadership of our leader, Mr. Jitendra Reddy, we went and approached the finance minister, sir, requested. Sir, in spite of the recommendation made by the Niti Aayog, they have not come forward to allocate this 5,000 crores for this machine Kakatiya. Sir, there is another machine, that is Machine Bhagiritha. Sir, nowhere in the country, sir, our Chief Minister, Mr. K. Chandrasekhar Rao, KCR has took a decision that each household in the state of Telangana, right from a tribal hamlet to the city of Hyderabad, every household should have a tap connection with filter water, sir.
No echo, but
sir, for this program, now an allocation of 40,000 crores was made and it is in progress, sir. Here also the Niti Aayog has proposed 19,000 crores as grant to the state of Telangana. Sir, unfortunately, the Honorable Prime Minister, in spite of repeated requests from our Honorable Chief Minister, many times our Chief Minister KCR had met the Honorable Prime Minister and made a request to release these funds, which was proposed by the Niti Aayog, his own brainchild, Niti Aayog. After seeing all these projects, they have recommended. But unfortunately, sir, not even a rupee was allocated. Sir, now on this day, we are requesting the Honorable Chief Minister, while replying to the no confidence motion, he should, the Honorable Prime Minister, while replying to the no confidence motion, he should answer and he should ensure that these allocations are made to the state of Telangana. Sir, there are many other issues with regard to the Bifurcation Act, that is AP State Reorganization Act. Sir, today they made a request that they want tax incentives. Sir, yes, the other special status states, they have these tax incentives. Sir, regarding allocation of funds, regarding allotment of some schemes to them, we are not coming in their way, sir. We don't have any objection also, sir. Sir, in the year 2014, when there was a discussion on tax incentives, Congress Party Chief Minister from Karnataka and the senior MP, Mr. Veerappa Moli, also opposed. And your leader, former Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Madam Jayalalitha, also opposed and had written a letter to the Government of India regarding the tax incentives. Sir, sir, you see, please wait. Sir, I want to ask Mr. Rahul Gandhi today. Very recently, there was a statement in the press that as and when, in the event, if they come to power in 2019, they are ensuring special status to the state of Andhra Pradesh. Do they mean that they are also going to give tax incentives? That we want to know. The people of Telangana want to know it, sir. Because neither them nor we want to hear false promises, sir. What is special status? That should be defined. Or you redefine it. There is no act for a special status, Mr. It is a decision of the national.
Please,
you mentioned, you did not speak, you don't know.
Please wind up. Please, sir.
You
please.
See, There is no act for special status. It is a decision of the National Development Council regarding giving special status to any state. So
Vinod Kumar, please wind up.
Sir, I want to know from the Bharatiya Janata Party leadership and also Congress Party leader, Mr. Rahul Gandhi ji, they should specify what is special status, what they want to.
No, they are forgot by the government has put it
off. Sir, this is very important, sir. Sir, this fighting should not continue even after 2019.
No, that is different issue.
No, it should
different
come to a logical conclusion.
What are your points,
sir? It should come to a logical conclusion. Sir, my contention is that the assurance given in the AP State Reorganization Act for my state, Telangana, should be fulfilled.
Okay,
and the Honorable Prime Minister, while replying in his to the debate, he should answer us. And also, I request Mr. Rahul Gandhi ji also to respond to my... Because how can they say that they will ensure special status to state of Andhra Pradesh?
Do they mean that they are going to tax incentive
dollars? All right.